Hello and welcome. There's still a lot to do other than answering a question, what skills you bring to the job. At the same time, there's something, what is that you bring to the organization? What is that you bring as a strength to the organization? So let's try and attempt this particular question holistically and see how better we can grow on our understanding. Employers ask this question to learn the skills, qualities, and qualifications that make you the best fit for both the role and the employer. Review the job description to tailor your answer to what's most compelling for the employer. Include a mix of hard and soft skills you are most frequently rewarded or complimented for. When preparing for an interview, it's important to consider your responses to questions that hiring managers may ask. One of the most popular questions is, what can you bring to the company or to the organization? You might hear this question in other form like, how would you bring value to the position? Or why should I hire you rather than any other candidate? In this particular shoot, we are going to deal with every question that we have mentioned now. Why employers ask, what can you bring to the company? Hiring managers want to find an employee that possesses the necessary skills to be successful in the open role. But they also often seek someone who can offer a new perspective to the business. Your answer to the question, what can you bring to the company, can demonstrate the value that only you can offer to the business. In your response, explain why your skills, experience, and characteristics uniquely position you to advance organizational objectives. How to answer? What can you bring to the company? Consider following few tips. First of all, research the company website. Most companies have a website that contains valuable information such as mission statement. Learning more about the mission statement will help you understand if your career goals and core values align with the employer's. After your research, consider how to frame your response in a way that speaks to these values. Biographies. Some company websites include information about some of its most important members, such as C-level executives and upper-level management. Learning more about leading employees can give you insight into their goals and how you can contribute towards reaching them. About Us page. Research the About Us page to gain more knowledge about the company's culture, history, products, and services. You should also see if there's any information about customers or company activities in this section of the website. Doing so can help you identify the areas in which you can make an impact on the organization. Review the company's social media and professional networking accounts. Now are the times where we are most volatile and most vibrant operating social media. So explore any social media accounts the company maintains. You can see if the business participates in any volunteer programs or if they have announced any recent successes. You can also read reviews about the organization on the company pages, where you will also find a Q&A section, salaries, company information and more. Get it there. Gather any information that might be useful when creating your response. For example, if an employee review states that there are multiple training courses to learn new skills, you can highlight how you strive to learn more about different roles to help your team. Study the job description. Very, very important for me. The job description includes the duties and responsibilities associated with the position. Review the description for any requirements that corresponds with your experience. Make sure to include examples of how you displayed those skills in previous positions or maybe during your journey of academics. You can mention soft skills such as critical thinking, hard skills that are specific to the job. For example, if you are applying for an accounting role, you can talk about your experience with programs such as QuickBooks or Sage. Make a list of your core values. Very important. Aim to connect your career goals and core values with anything similar to the company to help the interviewer understand why you are the perfect candidate for that particular job. To make a list of your core values, try to answer these questions. What qualities do I want to develop to excel in my career? What motivates me? What kind of work culture do I prefer? What qualities do I admire most in my role models? Fifth, practice your communication skills. By practicing your verbal and non-verbal communication skills, you improve your confidence when you deliver your answer. Be clear, concise when speaking. Remember the highlights of your response instead of memorizing all of it, as it may sound robotics. Maintain eye contact, sit upright, and keep your shoulders back to show that you are focused on the interview. Keep your feet flat on the ground for an inviting posture. Use a STAR interview response always. The STAR method is an effective way to structure your answer as you provide examples of experiences that speaks to your skill set. And STAR stands for situation. Describe the situation. Task, T stands for task. Explain your role in the situation. A for action, discuss the action you took to resolve or improve the situation. Results, R for results, describe and measure the outcome of the situation. Wow, STAR. What can you bring to the company? Your response to this question will depend on your experience and the company, but you can review your examples, answer for ideas like, number one, my problem-solving abilities allow me to work extremely well under pressure, which I understand is a common occurrence in this role. In a previous position as the purchasing lead, I had to decide which supplies to order to stay within the budget. But I had a limited amount of time to make a decision. I quickly created a spreadsheet that helped me compare manufacturer prices and was able to order the necessary supplies on time and within our budget. I used the spreadsheet throughout the rest of my time with the company to help them save over 5 lakhs. I will bring the same interest and motivation for making an impact here with your company. So problem-solving skills are important in any industry. Delivering a response that demonstrates this ability will show hiring managers you are willing to work through any challenge. Now, let us also look at some more examples. Example number 2. I believe my experience with the first company aligns perfectly with your requirement. I worked extensively with the program as a graphic designer at my earlier company. We had one client that wanted a large advertising campaign that included flyers, postcards, and magazine print advertisements. I worked almost exclusively with the old company to create most of the material. The client was so satisfied with the campaign that they continue to use our marketing even today for all of their advertisement needs. My technical design skills paired with my passion for great customer service will make me successful in this particular role. What a way to answer. See, most of the jobs require hard skill in addition to soft skills. Hard skills will fetch you a job, but soft skills will definitely help you to grow. So you need to find a balance of what you do in hard skills and be able to comfortably explain it to interviewer what is that which you have learned while doing that hard skills. If you can give an example of your experience that you have done during your internship or project or your voluntary work before landing up to the first job, I think it will make a lot of sense. And remember, a hard skill that was listed on the job description, you can distinguish yourself from the other candidates, because that is the starting line where you start building your resume and start preparing for the examples. And once, if you have already established the examples that you are going to give in front of the interviewer, I think it's like spelling the battle won. As soon as you differentiate this, definitely stand out among the other competitors of yours and help the hiring manager remember you distinctly. So the next time when a question comes across, what is that you bring to the company and what is that you bring to the job is specific to you your hard skills and your soft skills. But when it is company, you need to go beyond your hard and soft skills and think about the company, how you can benefit overall in the company's environment with your own maybe education, your experience, your learnings, and whatever you have done as of now. I hope we have discussed this exhaustively to bring about a great relevance into the topic. If you are able to demark what is that you bring to the job and what is that you bring to the company, I think it will be a great, great time worth spending on preparing for our interview. Best wishes. Thank you.